Hello, Mordimers here, and welcome to the quarterfinals of Lindores Abbey Rapid Challenge 2020, the tournament online part of Magnus Carlsen Tour. And today I would like to show you one of the games from quarterfinals where Magnus Carlsen, and number one in the world with the rapid ranking 2881, gonna play as white against Wesley So, Filipinian Grandmaster, who moved to USA, played under a USA flag, and his ranking, rapid ranking, 2741. So he's number 21 in this time format in the world. So without further ado, let's jump into the game. Magnus Carlsen open with d4. We have knight on f6, c4, e6, and now knight c3. Bishop on b4, so Nimzo Indian defense, and now queen on c2 is the one of the most popular move. E3 is also very popular, but knight on f3 is much more flexible, and this is what Magnus Carlsen played. And now b6 with the idea of bishop b7 is the most common here. Also d5 transposing to Ragozin defense with the bishop on b4 in queen's gambit decline, that's also possible. But here after knight on f3, Wesley saw first castle, and now we have bishop on g5, pinning the knight, and the knight also here is pinned, and it can be very tricky position. After c5, which was played by Wesley So, there are similar ideas like in Cambridge Springs variation of Queen's Gambit declined, with the queen on a5, knight jumping to e4, and then could be very unpleasant. However, in this variation, white always have time to take on f6, so there are not much issues. However, for example, in Cambridge Spring variation, then white always have to watch out on the bishop on g5, as if the knight is moved, then it can be even lost. So very interesting and rich in ideas opening. We have rook on c1 now supporting the knight on c3. We have c takes on d4 and knight takes on d4. And as I mentioned before, bishop on g5 can be undefended. Like for example now. Of course it's not risky now, because if queen a5, then the knight always can be taken. This is why we have h6 here, bishop on h4, and now d5 by Wesley So. We have c takes on d5, and now g5, kicking the bishop even further, because all of these ideas, or even these ideas, would not be possible, because the knight, you know, would be lost. So we have g5, bishop on g3, and only now queen on d5. We have e3, so now preparing to develop the bishop, and queen on a2, winning the pawn, which is quite natural in this opening. We have queen on c2, so this position actually was reached by Magnus Carlsen against Ding Liren, and Ding Liren play knight on d5, and after h4, knight on c3, as this knight is pinned, so knight on c3, b takes on c3, then exchanging the queens and bishop e7, and the game ended in a draw, as white have much more activity for the pieces, easier to attack the position of black king, so black have to be very careful and play quite precise. And so that was a draw. However, after knight on c3, there is a very interesting line where white sacrifice whole piece, don't care about the queen side, and play h takes on g5. And after knight on a4, with the discovered check, king d1, queen b2, and after exchanging king c2, and here if the knight is moved back to a4, the problem is it always of course can be taken with the king back, but rook on h6 with the idea of bishop on e5 and some mating ideas on h8, and it's very very dangerous attack. The bishop can also join the party, and that's gonna be crushing. So usually h takes on g5 is played here, and this position Believe me or not, Black has two extra pawns. Two extra pawns, but believe me or not, Peter Lecco as Black just draw his game. And there are a couple of games in database where it's just a draw. So White have, you know, a very beautiful activity, and the pieces are much better coordinated here. So it's not so easy, you know, for Black to continue. However, Wesley So in this position didn't go for knight on d5. He played bishop on c3 first, queen on c3, and now he goes with the knight on e4 with tempo and attack on the queen and the bishop. We have queen on c2 and now queen a5. Dislocating the king. So king has to be moved now, cannot be defended, because this knight makes a really great job and controlling, you know, c3 and d2 squares. So we have king on e2, and look at the position. If you look at this position, who gonna play like this? This bishop is blocked. Black have some pieces already in attack on the king's position. It looks like, you know, amateur play this game. Very interesting position, but what to play now? Because Black's knight is under attack and something has to be done. If, for example, is defended, the problem is after f3, the knight have to be, you know, moved anyway. So knight on f6, king f2, and now the position is very beautiful. White gonna develop the pieces pretty easily, and that's gonna be pretty dangerous for Black, you know, to continue, especially with, you know, lack of development on the queen side. So Wesley So don't want to waste the time, and he play knight on g3. The problem is now the h file is open, so it's possible to attack on the king side. We have king on g7, and now f4, preparing to crack the position of the black king. And now f6 is not really great, you know, to support the pawn, because it would create a lot of weaknesses on the light squares. These squares can be attacked very easily with the queen and light square bishop. Just, you know, white would have to coordinate the pieces. So Wesley So goes for development. We have bishop on d7, and here Magnus could just continue, you know, with king on f2, very natural move, knight c6, develop the bishop, and the position is better for him. This is what he could play. However, he goes for initiative, full initiative, and he plays b4. Before sacrificing another pawn, because he knows that this position, even if he's down two pawns, is still very active for white. I show you already one position, and it's very, very dangerous for black. However, black doesn't have much choice moving the queen. Where to move queen? Maybe on d8. And then the queen still can keep eye on g5, but it would be very, very passive. Wesley So took on b4, and now there are a couple of problems in his position. First, the queen doesn't look at g5 anymore, so that's the first thing. But also, rook on b1 with the attack on b7 is possible, and Magnus is gonna exploit that. So first we have f takes on g5. And now, what would you play as black in this position? It's quite tricky. H takes on g5, it looks like the most natural move. The problem is, as I said, rook on b1, the queen has to be moved. And now first rook on h7, and this is pretty dangerous. So king on f6, rook on h6, king e7, so it looks like the king is in the safety. The problem is, as I said, rook on b7. And you would ask, hey, because you're gonna lose this rook, that's not really great. Yes, but it doesn't really matter, because after queen on a6, white actually have knight b5. Knight b5. And the knight cannot be taken by the bishop, because bishop is pinned. And if queen on b7, the problem is queen c5 with check. And look at this king. King has no squares. If king on e8, then we would have this beautiful fork. So that's not an option. But king d8 doesn't help also, because white gonna win back the material. And now what to play? Bishop e8 is the only move. And now winning the piece and the game. Queen e8. You see that? That's a very, very beautiful. So white would just be up the material, extra bishop, of course, is enough to win the game. So that's pretty crazy. But what else to play as black here? The engine suggests as the only move knight on c6, and this is the only move. So g takes on h6, giving back the material, giving back the pawn, and now king h8, knight goes back on f3 as it attacked twice, so knight f3, and then just continue the game from this position. And actually the engine says that it's better for black. Not sure about that, but black has, you know, quite solid position, so that's probably possible if the engine says so. However, here, very interesting move, rook on c8, kicking the queen first, okay, before taking on g5. The problem is, this is losing move. And feel free actually to pause the video and find the winning continuation for Magnus while I enjoy my cup of tea. Okay, ready? So the first move, of course, is h takes on g5 with check. The pawn cannot be taken with the support of the rook, that's not possible. So king on h8, actually doesn't matter what move black gonna play. Next move is the same, queen on c8, sacrificing the queen, or maybe exchanging the queens for the rook and the bishop. An incredible activity, and also lack of development by black pieces. This is the biggest issue here, because after bishop on c8, the only move, rook on c8, and now this piece is not gonna be developed at all. It's impossible. We have king on h7 and now knight on f3. And look at this. If black try, for example, a5, just maybe bring the rook to the game and trying to attack the king somehow, knight g5 ends the game. King g6, there is no other move. King on g6, but now rook on g8, king f6, and now you cannot stop this pawn from promoting, so it's not possible. So the only move now is f6, okay, f6, but it still doesn't help. Okay, the knight cannot jump, but king f2 with the idea, just, you know, develop the bishop, bishop d3, and this is just crashing. So Wesley So tried to lock the bishop. We have bishop on e2, so now the bishop is locked. But now how to crack this position? Look at this. That's a little stronghold by Magnus, and his king is so super safe there. And now what now? A5 still doesn't work, because now rook on c7 with check, king h8, the only move, and now knight h4, so knight gonna join the party. And here black doesn't have any choice here. It's actually mating net, and white gonna just win. Even if develop all the pieces now, you know, all the pieces are free, that's not enough. Knight on g6, king g8, and we have a checkmate. So, incredible. So, Wesley saw last chance, desperate move, knight on a6, sacrificing the rook, but he has nothing else to do. Rook on a8 and knight c5. So, he trying to coordinate the knight and the queen in the attack. But look at this stronghold. This is just impossible. We have rook on d1 now with the idea of bringing the rook, of course, to the attack on the king. However, the pawn is undefended. Can it be taken? If it's taken, actually, rook g8 just cutting the king and all is done. Knight e4 is possible because a king on g1 and the rook cannot, you know, checkmate here. A queen on e2 is possible, but then rook d7 and mate is coming. Queen e3. King h2, and what now? There are no moves. F5, but knight h4 joining the party, and as you see, this is gonna be a checkmate. After the king move to h5, then we're gonna have a checkmate. So not this way. H5 just prolongs a bit, but it doesn't really matter, as white gonna have extra rook and win the game. So the pawn cannot be taken. Wesley So play knight on e4. We have king on g1 and now f5. trying to make maybe some escaping path for the king. And now Magnus goes for the easiest possible solution, just exchange the knight. Okay, so bishop on d3 and trying to exchange the knight. We have queen on f2 with check, and now king h1, inviting actually black to take on g3. However, it would not work because knight on g3, king h2, and what you gonna do now? What you gonna play? A queen cannot move because the knight is, you know, undefended. The knight cannot jump to f1 because it's defended. And what can be done? King h6, rook e8, eliminate all the pawns and win the game. Knight is still under attack, so queen cannot move. If knight on h5, then simply rook e6 with check. Now bishop takes on f5, and this is just crashing, and white gonna win. Actually, that's gonna be a checkmate very soon. So Wesley So goes for a queen on e3, maybe trying to create some passed pawn here. And now we have bishop on e4, f takes on e4. And now rook on d7, checking the king. And now if king takes on h6, it doesn't really help, because rook on h8, king g6, now rook g8, king f6, rook f8, and now the king has to go back because the knight controls e5. Very nice coordinated pieces. So king g6, but now knight can join the party. Knight e5 with check. King g5, and now rook g7, king h6, rook f on f7, and checkmate is coming. Nothing can be done. Queen e1, just one check. And now e3, trying to promote that, that's too late. You've seen already that mating idea, rook on g6, and it's still in the air, and now that would be a checkmate. So instead of taking the pawn, we have king on g6, but after rook on g8, there is you know, the same continuation with the knight joining the party, and the checkmate is coming anyway. So in this position, actually, Wesley So resigned the game. In the second game, this was the first game in their mini match, and in the second game Wesley So also lost in the very promising, actually winning position. He was exchanged up and he had a very nice position, possible win, but Magnus Carlsen managed to defend and actually he won the game after Wesley So just make some inaccuracies, then mistake, and then he just won the game. And in the last game they had the draw, so 2.5 to 1/2. So first mini match was won by Magnus, so 1-0, and Wesley So is still in the game. He still have, you know, have the chance to win two mini matches and eliminate Magnus, but it's gonna be very, very difficult. So yeah, if you like this video, press like. If for some reason you don't like it, press unlike. And if you don't want to miss another games, press subscribe, smash the bell button. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.